Left chest pain. Left-sided chest pain evokes a fear in the mind of the patient as well as the doctor, whether it is related to the heart and is it an heart attack. The typical anginal pain is experienced in the central and left chest, and it may radiate along the medial aspect of the left arm or to the left lower jaw and teeth. But there are several other conditions giving rise to chest pain, and they have to be thought of in this context. So how do we approach a patient with left chest pain and arrive at a diagnosis? A well-taken history often makes the diagnosis clear. First ask, how did the pain start? Was there trauma or unusual exertion like lifting some weight? If yes, the diagnosis is obvious. Palpate the painful area and find out whether there is a rib fracture clinically or just a contusion or muscle sprain. If fracture crepitus or severe tenderness is present, ask for an X-ray of the chest for ribs. Don't forget to mention that you want an X-ray for the ribs. You must mention this to the radiologist because the exposures required for lungs and ribs are different, and you cannot detect a rib fracture in an X-ray which is taken for lungs. If there is no history of injury, ask whether there is associated fever and cough. Fever indicates an infective condition, usually in the lungs and pleura. Conditions like pericarditis or mediastinitis are extremely rare, so mainly think of lung and pleural infections. If along with fever, cough and tachypnea are present, think of pleuritis and pneumonia. If patient is looking very ill with tachycardia, tachypnea and high fever, one can be almost certain on pneumonia. The third question is, does the pain increase during deep inspiration or coughing? If it does, pleural involvement is definite. Ask for an X-ray of the chest and WBC count. Let me stress again, if there is pain on inspiration, do not just treat the patient symptomatically. Get him investigated early. Otherwise, you will miss an early case of pleuritis or pneumonia or tuberculosis. Pain while breathing is a serious symptom. The fourth question is the pain related to exertion? Is there pain while walking uphill or upstairs? How much distance can the patient walk before the pain appears? Or asking in another way, how many times does he stop due to pain if he walks about a kilometer? Then, does the pain disappear quickly in 2 to 3 minutes if he stops and takes rest? If the pain is very specifically related to exertion, it is most likely to be anginal pain. The last question is it related to food? Does it increase on swallowing or after a heavy meal? And is it associated with sour eructations? This history should be asked in details when the pain is retrosternal and burning type. It will suggest reflux esophagitis or hiatus hernia. To quickly recollect, we asked whether there was any history of trauma. Is there fever and cough suggesting infection? Does the pain increase during inspiration suggesting pleural inflammation? Is the pain related to exertion or walking? And is it related to meals and the act of swallowing? Now we will come to the examination of this patient. Whenever a patient complains of left-sided or retrosternal chest pain, first have a general look at the patient. If he is sweating, restless, uneasy, that is a dangerous sign suggesting myocardial infarction. First check the pulse and blood pressure. If pulse is feeble or irregular, and if the blood pressure is low, take it as myocardial infarct. Give him a tablet of plain aspirin, one tablet of sublingual sorbitrate, one analgesic injection, and immediately take him to a hospital. If the patient is walking or moving very cautiously, trying not to move the chest, then probably he is having severe pleural pain, as in pleurisy or empyema or a rib fracture. If the patient is looking toxic, there is high fever, lots of cough and grossly dyspneic, then probably he has a lobar pneumonia. After general examination, examine the chest. First, palpate for tenderness over the area of chest pain. Palpate over the ribs for rib fracture and also in between the ribs for intercostal tenderness, as seen in empyema or to some extent in pleurisy. Palpate in the parasternal area by the side of the sternum over the costal cartilages for costochondritis. Never miss this step because this is the only way costochondritis can be diagnosed. If the tenderness is superficial over the muscles, then it is a simple myalgia or sprain. Then auscultate for crepes, bronchial breath sounds or reduced air entry. Specially, auscultate carefully over the area of pain for pleural rub. If the pain is in the upper part of the chest, then test the neck and shoulder movements for pain and palpate over the cervical spine, paraspinal area and shoulder joint for tenderness. Because pain may be referred to the upper chest from cervical spondylitis or from shoulder periarthritis. Lastly, if there are vesicles or scars of herpes zoster on the skin, think of postherpetic pain. Now we will discuss the investigations. For a simple myalgic pain, no investigations are required. Just reassure the patient and prescribe a rubefacient ointment, anti-inflammatory drugs and local fomentations. If there is pain on inspiration, severe cough or high fever, then X-ray of the chest and WBC count is a must. If the pain is related to exertion or walking, then ask for an ECG. If ECG is abnormal and suggests ischemic heart disease, then refer to a cardiologist. If the ECG is normal but the pain is definitely related to exertion, try TAB sorbitrate 1 TDS plus sublingual sorbitrate whenever there is pain. And if the pain is relieved by a sorbitrate, then treat it as angina and refer to a cardiologist for further evaluation. A normal ECG does not rule out angina. So, what we have learned in this lecture is that when a patient complains of left-sided or retrosternal chest pain, we must have a high suspicion of possible angina or myocardial infarct. At the same time, we must also think of other conditions that may give rise to pain in that area and rule them out by proper history, examination and, if necessary, investigations. After all that hurts in the left chest is not just heart.